it's me, Pallavi, welcoming you all to Life in Size with Pallavi. Today we're doing a DIY video, which is my absolute favorite kind of video to do because I love making things, I love creating things, especially when I'm creating things out of already used things. So when I'm reusing stuff in my house, when I'm using scraps, when I'm using all kinds of junk to create something new and beautiful, frugal living for the win. So today we're going to learn how to reuse all our old candles melted bits. So like you know, I got married a year and a half ago, and when I did up my own house, I was very excited every time somebody was coming over, and I had tons of these beautiful scented candles all over the house, and every time literally anybody would come over, I just light up all the candles and have a nice warm, cozy, lovely smelling apartment. But all these candles turned out to be really expensive, and me being the smart chimney girl that I am, I saved up all the melted bits like this. So I had these beautiful pillar scented candles from Pure, and I picked up loads of them, and these like this size, okay maybe it was about this much, was 260 bucks, and the one which is about like this big was 500 bucks, and it was crazy to keep going on spending that kind of money on scented candles, but they just smell so lovely. And I still have my Bath & Body Works candles which I haven't even touched, but you know, they smell amazing, and it feels like a waste to just, you know, have them on for an hour or so and then waste like this much. So anyway, I picked up all of these bits, and today I'm going to reuse all of these and make a beautiful new candle out of them. So for that, all we need is these melted candle bits, some kind of a mold or something to make a candle in. So I, frugal living, this is this beautiful water holder that I got from Pure, and I broke it, so I still saved it, and I'm going to make the candle. I'm going to like set the candle in this in the hope of being able to pull it out and make a pillar candle. Just in case it is a failed experiment, the candle will be in this, and it's still something pretty to hold it in. I also need these candle wicks, which I bought from Itsy Bitsy, which is my absolute favorite craft store. I got 10 of these 4-inch wicks for 50 bucks, which is not bad at all. Then you're going to, so I'm already using scented candles. If your candles are not scented, or if they're not colored, so if they're not colored, you can just throw in bits of crayons and melt them along with the wax and give it any color you want. And if it's not scented, you know, you can just use some essential oil that you have lying around in the house. I'm also going to experiment by adding some fresh basil that is growing in my own terrace. I think it's going to make the whole house smell amazing. And I'm also thinking I just might add in these beautiful dried flowers, because look how cute they are. I mean, I guess it'll work better with a transparent, like a whitish candle, but I'm going to give it a shot anyway. So let's get started. Let's go and make these candles, in melt this in a double boiler. But first, make sure you give this video a big thumbs up, like it, make sure you subscribe to my channel so you keep getting these amazing, exciting videos with loads and loads of tips and tricks. And let's get started. All right, let's do this. This is the real exciting part about this, where I will stand in the kitchen and feel like a mad scientist doing all kinds of crazy experiments. So I need a saucepan, some hot water. Here I've got again a reused tin from Indigo, which was like for cookies or something, or popcorn. And or you can just use a glass jar. I've got my melted candle bits in this. Just hold it, safety first, and I'm just gonna try and melt this. Okay, so the wax has now melted, and it looks beautiful and molten and also a little dangerous. And now the next few steps, which are basically just going to be me winging it, alright? So are you ready? I've got my mold thingy ready. And I have a feeling like I should brush it with oil if I want it to come out. Don't know if I should, but I have that feeling, so I'm gonna do it anyway. Now, the wick is supposed to be, according to the videos I saw, with the glue gun you fix it on the base. But again, I want the candle to come out, so I'm not sure how that works. So what I'm going to do is, again, winging it, pour in some of the melted wax, like a tiny bit. And now I'm going to add this. and add the rest of the wax in. Now I'm going to stop at this stage and add some of the flowers that I had planned. Don't think that's going to look very nice. Basil. This is looking a bit too childish, but let's see. Okay, so it's time for the big reveal. I have waited about 5 hours for this candle to cool down. It's still a little warm, but I'm running out of patience now. So there you have it. That's what it looks like. Although I have a sneaky suspicion this is not gonna come out. I'm still gonna give it a shot. Here goes nothing. This is a bad idea. But that is why I took a pretty votive in the first place. So make sure you do that. Or what I've researched in the last few hours is that you need some sort of a plastic mold which you can kind of tear off and destroy. So that works. Otherwise, just pick out a pretty votive holder or any nice jar and then you can decorate it with spray paints or some mirrors or whatever, right? So my pretty votive and my beautiful candle are ready. It's still a win. Also, most of the videos I saw online for making a candle said that you must trim your wick now. You don't want to, but I've experimented too much on my own today, so let's just go with what they're saying. So I'm gonna trim the wick and leave about half an inch out, and let's burn it and see. So there you have it. It was really as easy as that. My candle is burning, the house is smelling lovely now, and I just had so much fun actually getting down to doing this finally. So leave me your comments if you try this method out, or if you have some suggestions on how to make this better. Leave me pictures of the candles you make inspired by this one, and keep tuning in to Life Princess Size with Pallavi.